even in the history, if you hear the story when Hulagu and the Tatar soldiers invaded Iraq and killed the Khalifa, killed millions of Muslims, and they made the blood of Muslims run on the streets. The blood of Muslims used to run on the street like water when it rains. This is how much Muslims were killed. And the big library that was in Baghdad, they took it and they destroyed it in the river of Iraq, to the point that the water of the river changed because of the ink of the books. If this didn't happen, we would have had more books for those scholars that were before the Tatar invasion. Sheikh, they were not merciful. They used to kill the infants inside the womb of their moms. Slaughtering, killing, burning alive, everything, every area in which they used to go, they used to kill all. One day they wanted to enter a city. Hulagu said, why use my soldiers? So he sent a letter to the people who are in the city that if you surrender, I will come in and I will make you rulers of that city. So those people believed the enemy. Silly people. They believed the enemy, ya Rajul, and they wanted ad-dunya. They said, instead of making jihad, we will convince the people of the city that we will make an alliance with Hulagu, and we will be the rulers later on, money, gold, dunya, prestige, kaza. So they started to convince the people. Some people didn't agree. So those people who didn't agree with them to surrender to Hulagu, those that were given the promise to be rulers, killed them. Muslims killing Muslims, for sure, for the kursi, for the rule. Allahu Akbar, and we are all going to the tomb. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. So they killed all those who were opposing them, and then they went to the beast, to their beast. We did like you want. The city is yours. Promised us rulership. We'll be the rulers. He said, I won't trust those who betrayed their own people. How can you not betray me? Kill them. He killed them. And his soldiers didn't even fight one time. See how the enemies work? Anyway, to finish, Hulagu had his son fighting against the Muslims. Sheikh, they invaded Iraq, they invaded here, there, killing. Yani if you read the story, the history, Allahu Akbar, Sheikh, Allahu Akbar. Someone weak would have said, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam will be annihilated, you say? Allahu Akbar, but the strong Muslim will say, Prophet Muhammad asked Allah that no enemy will come to his nation and annihilate all his nation, and Allah gave it to him. No one is able, no matter what, how strong he is, Ummat Muhammad, no one enemy will annihilate it. Is it clear? So what happened when they arrived to Ash-Sham? Taj al-Din al-Rifa'i and another wali among the Rifa'iyya took their students. They were 500 men of As-Sad al-Rifa'iyya, and they brought with them the lions, because al-Rifa'iyya, Allah gave them the ability to control the lions. So As-Sad al-Rifa'iyya, when the Tatar invaded Ash-Sham, what happened with them? 500 Rifa'is, they climbed the lions and they took in their hands not the swords, the snakes. Snakes, holding the snakes on lions, not on camels or on horses. And when the Tatar came to invade, they attacked them. They attacked them on the lions with the snakes. They made the heart of the Tatar so scared. And then it didn't finish here. Some of those awliya among the Rifa'iyya started to fly, as you are hearing. started to fly from their lions, they take one among those Tatar army. He flies with him to the big fire that they lit before the battle. They lit a very big fire. So while they are on the lions, they used to fly, take the Tatar soldier to the fire that they lit, and they go out with only the hand of the Tatari man. All the rest of his body is burnt in the fire. The son of Hulako, because of that, embraced Islam, and he was called as Sultan Mahmud.